Right now at 5, a teenager who allegedly shot and killed a 15-year-old last year enters into a plea deal today. Hear the strong message from the judge about his thoughts on minors and gun control. And UWL students are reacting to a deal that's limiting diversity, equity, and inclusion positions.
You're watching WKBT La Crosse. This is News 8 Now at 5.
Good evening and thanks for watching News 8 Now at 5. I'm Emily Brown. Ken is off tonight. The teen accused of shooting and killing 15-year-old Storm Vondrashek in 2022 is guilty. As part of a plea deal, 19-year-old Sage Hickey pled no contest today in La Crosse County Court to one count of felony possession of a firearm and one count of felony intimidation of a witness. The charges of first-degree intentional homicide and disorderly conduct were dismissed as part of the deal. At today's sentencing hearing, two of the victim's family members read statements. Judge Levine had a strong message about the accessibility of guns to minors.
Guns are killers. They kill people. I understand it's people who shoot them, but guns are the mechanism we kill people with.
Hickey is sentenced to 2 years in jail and 4 years of extended supervision. One person is dead and another injured after an early morning UTV crash in Harper's Ferry. According to the Alamakee County Sheriff's Office, a UTV was driving in a rural part of the county after midnight. At a curve, the driver drove into a ditch and rolled the vehicle. The driver died in the crash and a passenger was airlifted to a La Crosse hospital. The Sheriff's Office is still investigating the accident. This week, Universities of Wisconsin Regents approved a deal with Republican legislators to limit diversity positions on its campuses. The deal is in exchange for money to cover staff raises and construction projects, but it's causing negative reaction from many students. News 8 Now's Jeremy Wall is learning what UWL students are saying about it.
Emily, UWL students tell me having diversity, equity, and inclusion positions are critical because they don't see a lot of diversity on campus. College Simply, a source for information on colleges, reports 90% of UWL student body is white. The Regents voted on Wednesday to reverse their decision they made last weekend. According to Assembly Speaker Robin Voss, the plan is the first step in a continuing GOP effort to eliminate DEI positions. The deal would freeze hiring for those who run diversity programs through the end of 2026. I spoke with Emma Whitman, the senator of the Asian Organization Association. She says the deal is unfair to students like her.
Our diversity numbers are already incredibly low. And it's a step in the wrong direction. I think the compromise that they made recently with the Board of Regents was a bit better than the proposed solution earlier this year, but it's still a step in the wrong direction.
The deal has also left Governor Tony Evers unhappy. Evers accuses Voss of negotiating by bullying and is promising to make sure the campuses are for everyone. Coming up at 6, I'll be talking to more students about their reactions to DEI positions being limited. Emily.
All right, thank you, Jeremy. The Global Climate Conference wrapped in Dubai earlier this week, and nations walked away with a historic deal. The final agreement calls for transitioning away from fossil fuels. Emissions from oil, gas, and coal are the main driver of climate change. La Crosse Mayor Mitch Reynolds attended the conference as part of the first local climate action summit. He was there to speak about the work of the Mississippi River Cities and Towns Initiative. Reynolds says that while the final deal may not have been as productive as some had hoped, it is still a step in the right direction.
I don't think we can lose track of the fact that that at least was an incremental change and some acknowledgement that moving away from fossil fuels will be necessary for our future.
The climate agreement also aims to triple the amount of renewable energy sources, reduce methane emissions, and achieve net zero carbon emissions globally. Well, it was a gloomier one today and warmer compared to yesterday, and it looks like we have a few more days of that ahead, right, Greg?
Yeah, we have rain that's coming in the forecast, especially further north as you go right now. We're starting to see rain actually push into Ladysmith and just north of Eau Claire. But for currently temperatures, it's been actually fairly nice right now, still upper 30s to near 40, so overall still a good condition. Day, we just had more cloud cover. We have rain up to the north that's beginning to push into the area. Really, as you go towards the Twin Cities, this band starting to develop. Overall, Eau Claire, just cloud cover right now, not much in the way of rain, but you go further north, you're starting to see some of that begin to fall. For La Crosse, it's going to be a while too, just cloudy conditions are expected overnight. Big picture shows really as we zoom out, you can kind of see where that front is, one to the north, and there's a system to the north that's going to be pulling up. That'll be more for southern Wisconsin and for Saturday's rain. The one to the north is what we're looking for tonight. Overall for La Crosse, like sprinkle or two possible, but this evening should be dry, just cloudy conditions with temperatures around the upper 30s near 40. Eau Claire will start seeing the rain developing here and then quite widespread and steady light rain as we go throughout the evening with temperatures still in the upper 30s, so kind of a chilly rain. Further up, we'll kind of break down, time out the rain, what we expect for tomorrow. Winter does return briefly on Monday, but could we see another 50 next week before Christmas? I'll break all that down a bit later in the broadcast.
Oh boy, another one potentially. All right, thank you, Greg. Since the reversal of Roe v. Wade, new data shows Minnesota has seen an uptick in patients from out of state getting abortions. From 2020 to 2023, the number of out of state patients coming to Minnesota for an abortion jumped from 9% to 30%. That's according to data tracked by the Guttmeier Institute. Nationwide, 1 in 5 patients traveled across state lines for an abortion. Minnesota also has a so-called shield law designed to protect providers and people who come here for access. Minnesota citizens concerned for life criticizes the state's policies as extreme, and they say they're out of step with what Minnesotans want.
Sadly, our DFL leadership and Governor Walz would prefer to encourage abortion tourism over the true tourism that most Minnesotans desire for this state.
Next year, DFL leaders at the Capitol plan to discuss a constitutional amendment to explicitly put rights in the state constitution. Well, the message is clear. Lithium-ion batteries improperly made or used can be explosive. U.S. officials have counted nearly 400 incidents this year involving lithium-ion batteries, including fires that are blamed for killing 49 people. New York City Fire Commissioner Laura Cavanaugh has been vocal about the lithium-ion batteries, especially in e-bikes and e-scooters, as the number of related deaths has skyrocketed.
These will go from, you know, nothing to a sudden explosion of fire. We see first responders not able to get in. Often within minutes of the call being reported, they're arriving to a building that is fully engulfed in flames.
Now, there are no mandatory federal safety standards for lithium-ion batteries, but manufacturers and sellers can comply with voluntary industry standards. To stay safe as possible, don't mix batteries and chargers. Don't charge batteries at extreme temperatures or for too long. Don't leave them charging unattended or near flammable items.
I do think they can be manufactured safely.
And don't block your exit path
eventually,
with these devices.
There's no guarantee of that right now, and I certainly especially...
Well, with Christmas just a little more than a week away, the time to ship your gifts is now. About 82 million packages a day will be shipped during this month's peak. About 4 million of them will pass through the UPS Mega Hub in Louisville, Kentucky per day. The packages come in by truck and by plane, get sorted by zip code, and loaded into giant shipping containers for an airplane out of town. That all happens in less than 4 hours. Captain Chad Gerber is an assistant chief pilot for UPS.
It is a joy to take packages from A to B and get them underneath the Christmas tree at the right time in the right place.
Now, the cutoff for 3-day shipping is Tuesday and next day shipping is Thursday. Christmas falls on a Monday this year. Well, just ahead, 3 hostages killed in the Israel-Hamas war. What the Israeli defense is saying about the killings and the controversy surrounding it, right after the break.
The countdown to Christmas is on, and Blaine's Farm and Fleet is your one-stop shop for all things holiday. Finish your shopping for less with great gifts at great prices for everyone on your list, like heated vehicle seat cushions or blankets, just $19.99. Shop select DeWalt power tools, $99, and these special buy pet beds, just $29.99. Rewards members save an extra $5. Plus, Blaine's Farm and Fleet gift cards always make perfect gifts.
Find value at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
Here you go.
Russell! I swear I've been seeing you everywhere.
I've been busy.
At Drury's in Fountain, Minnesota, we're making it easier than ever to furnish your home with name brand, top quality furniture. For a limited time, you'll save with store-wide sale prices. Plus, we'll pay your sales tax. Sofas and sectionals from Smith Brothers, Lazy Boy, and Flex Steel. Bedrooms and dining rooms from Canal Dover and Daniel's Amish. They're all at sale prices. And now, we'll pay your sales tax. But it's only for a limited time at Drury's in Fountain, Minnesota. Voted your favorite furniture store.
I did know that back pain, foot pain come along with the job of waiting tables.
This is Tony.
Things that I've tried have failed.
And this is Tony's good feet story.
Before my arch supports, I felt defeated. But since getting the arch supports from the good feet store, I have had no pain, which still is kind of crazy to me. I'm more positive. It's like opening up a whole new life, like sunshine coming up. I would recommend it to anyone. You've tried everything that's not working, give it a try.
See how we can help you too at the good feet store.
Time to nominate your favorite business for Best of La Crosse County. Make your nominations in each category now through December 31st. The top five in each category will move on to the final round. Nominate this business today on bestoflacrossecounty.com.
King's Hawaiian 12-count rolls, original and butter, $1.99 each. Hy-Vee pasta sauce for 99 cents. 24 ounces, limit of two. Buy $60 worth of groceries and receive 40 cents off per gallon at Hy-Vee Fast and Fresh.
During military operations in Gaza, the Israeli Defense Forces say three hostages were mistakenly identified as a threat and killed during fighting. The identities released do not include Americans who remain unaccounted for. The development comes as U.S. National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan visits the region. He's talking to leaders about the next phase of the war. Two U.S. officials say the Israelis have told the United States that the current phase of their offensive against Hamas could be complete in the next 2 to 3 weeks.
There will be a transition to another phase of this war, one that is focused in more precise ways on targeting the leadership and on intelligence-driven operations that continues to deal with the ongoing threat that Hamas poses.
Thank you once again.
The Israeli Defense Minister told Sullivan that particular phase of war could be a long one, lasting more than several months. Sullivan also met Friday with the Palestinian president, who lost control of Gaza when Hamas took over in 2007. The two discussed Gaza's future post-war, which still remains unclear. European officials have arrested multiple people with connections to Hamas for suspected terrorist activity. According to law enforcement, the suspects in Germany, Denmark, and the Netherlands were plotting to attack Jews. Lilia Luciano has the story.
In Germany, authorities said at least one of the suspects was assigned by Hamas to find weapons to be used in a future terrorist attack. Three people were arrested in Berlin on suspicion of planning attacks against Jewish people or institutions, and a fourth arrest was made in the Netherlands, all four suspected of being longtime Hamas members. While in Denmark, at least six people could also be facing charges related to terrorism. The prime minister said, "This is as serious as it gets." Intelligence officials in Denmark alerted the public to be aware of Jewish places of interest, saying the investigation revealed that a network of people had been preparing a terrorist attack. Zohar Palti ran counterterrorism for Israel's Mossad.
In this case, we see that Hamas already is conducting terror activity globally. When you see three countries in Europe, like Denmark, like Germany, and like Netherlands, this is something new, and I think we should be concerned about it.
EU officials have recently warned Europe faces a huge risk of terror attacks. And in the U.S., FBI Chief Christopher Wray testified earlier this month that he has never seen a time where all of the threats are elevated all at the same time. Lilia Luciano, CBS News, London.
Coming up, the former First Lady of the United States making a rare public appearance at a national institution. Hear what she had to say about American citizenship.
And though we have some rain this weekend and still mild conditions, we are going to go back quickly to December-type weather for Monday. Definitely a change, but that won't last long. I'll break down how long that'll last and what maybe Christmas looks like, all that coming up on your First Warm Weather Update after the break.
We're celebrating 100 years of business here at Wesco and Sparta. 100 years of furniture, 100 years of appliances, 100 years of mattresses, 100 years of flooring and windows. We'd like to say thank you to our customers by giving up to 23% off everything in the store. Wesco and Sparta, where white glove delivery and setup are always free. Thank you from 1923 to 2023, and tell them Peyton sent you.
The gift of relaxation and pampering is the perfect gift to give this holiday season. It is the Sue Colvey's experience. The gift your special someone is really hoping for, and the gift she really deserves. Order your gift cards online today at SueColvey's.com or pick them up at Sue Colvey's Salon and Day Spa, because she deserves the very best.
Get in a Jeep today at Pishke Motors in La Crosse or Pishke Motors in West Salem.
Stop in now during the Wrap Up the Year sales event. You'll get 12% off MSRP, including discounts on a new 2024 Jeep Grand Cherokee. The Grand Cherokee is ready for your next adventure. Pure comfort and functionality at your fingertips with the power and confidence you know Jeep provides. Stop in now because this offer ends January 2nd.
Start your search at Pishke.com and then drive away in your new Jeep.
News 8 Now and the Co-op Credit Union are taking part in Chase the Chill.
Chase the Chill is a project across North America that provides warm clothing to people in need. Scarves, hats, and gloves are hung on trees in parks with notes attached to them, letting people know they can take them.
Co-op Credit Union and our community are conducting our own Chase the Chill campaign from December through February.
Together, we can keep our community warm this winter.
Donations will be accepted at the Co-op Credit Union location in Onalaska.
Get 12% off all Masterforce till Christmas at Menards. With gifts so good, the stockings stuff themselves.
Former First Lady Melania Trump made a rare public appearance at the National Archives in Washington, D.C. Friday. The former First Lady was there to attend a naturalization ceremony for 25 new citizens from various nations. After they were sworn in, Mrs. Trump shared her long and personal immigration experience from arriving to the U.S. from Slovenia in 1996 and finally becoming a citizen in 2006.
For me, reaching the milestone of American citizenship marked the sunrise of certainty. At that exact moment, I forever discarded the layer of burden connected with whether I would be able to live in the United States. Be proud of yourself, stand your ground, and embrace the opportunities that lie ahead. You are American.
The appearance comes nearly 2 years after the National Archives and Record Administration asked the Justice Department to investigate former President Trump's handling of White House records. The former First Lady did not mention her husband in her remarks, who's campaigning on a hardline immigration agenda. Well, it's a big weekend for holiday parties and shopping. Will weather interfere with your commutes and plans? Let's send it over to Chief Meteorologist Greg Barnhart for our weather forecast.
Yeah, we definitely have rain in the forecast here for Saturday. It's going to impact some. It's not going to be much in the way of rain this part of the state, but further north towards Eau Claire, it could be steady light rain. Still mild this weekend, but we are going to take a tumble with the temperatures back down to below averages come Monday. The thing is, it's only going to be brief because that's going to come right back up to almost being 47 by the end of next week. So it's only going to be one day, but you'll definitely feel the chill for your start of your work week, especially as you wake up Monday morning. For the weekend, we have rain really for Saturday morning, Saturday for La Crosse. Eau Claire probably is going to wrap up in the morning hours. And then Sunday, less in the way of obviously dry conditions, but then more sun for probably La Crosse and less for Eau Claire, but it will be dry. But notice the temperature is still above average. So even with this, even though it's going to be kind of a chilly, cold rain, it's not going to be as cold as it could be. Overall, if you look at the timing, really by the time we get to 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, or midnight, most of the rain still is up to the north of La Crosse, centered right around I-94, a little bit further north towards Ladysmith. Could be some moderate rain in that. As it begins to sag south, it's not really going to do that. It's actually going to be pulled back to the west a little bit. So it'll be really starting to fill in from the system to the south. It'll bring rain up into the southern areas, especially south of La Crosse, as we go towards tomorrow morning. But this is going to be more generally light, occasional light, spotty here and there. The more steady rain will continue to be pushed off to the west. And as we go into Saturday afternoon, we'll start seeing areas up to the north kind of break up. It'll be occasional light rain, maybe a shower. Areas to the southern area as we get towards Viroqua, and then obviously southern Wisconsin, there'll be more occasional light rain through Saturday. And then for Saturday afternoon and evening, we'll have cloudy skies up to the north, probably drizzle occasionally. Temperatures overall not too bad. More of the light rain or showers to southern Wisconsin. But overall, as we go to Saturday night, it's just generally going to be cloudy, and you probably can't rule out even for Saturday evening to still continue to see some drizzle or some light rain, but most of the steady rain will be over with. So that's kind of what we're looking at. Rain, we're not expecting any type of snow right now with this system. That's the one thing. Only as you go much further north into far northern Wisconsin, just a little bit of a changeover, but even Ladysmith will stay all rain right now. So that's the good news with this system. There should be travel impacts besides the wet conditions. Amounts of rain really depends on where you are. About a tenth of an inch as you go further south, much more as you go further west. So that's what we're looking at right now. Big picture shows we do have that front coming, another front coming towards Monday, and these are the wind chills you could be waking up to as you come Monday morning. So it will be definitely a change. The good news, we're not expecting that. As we go towards next week, we do have the Christmas holiday coming up, so we're kind of keeping an eye on towards that weekend. We have a system that is approaching right now. It does look to be more rain. We'll see if that pans out, but something to keep in mind of. But otherwise, if you look at temperatures, really going to be in the low 40s, rain on and off for most of the area. As we go further south, similar type of story, and even up to the north, too. It's just going to be rain and just upper 30s to low 40s. Overall, if you look at the 8-day forecast, the windy conditions come with the colder air on Monday, and that'll be the coldest day of the period. Otherwise, we're going to have 40s for the rest of the week, and maybe 50. We'll
see. Wow, I can't believe it. But it's dropping pretty drastically on Monday, it looks like. All right. Okay, well, thank you, Greg. When we come back, it's the most wonderful time of the year. Find out what some lucky kids are being gifted this holiday season and the elves behind the unique crafts.
Energy-efficient windows with beautiful new wood trim installed by skilled carpenters. Contact the Board Store Home Improvements today for a prompt free estimate. High quality at lower prices.
It's time to light up the season during the Make the Holidays Bright sales event. Get our best offers and choose from a huge selection of Ford F-150 trucks with the capability, convenience, and technology to help bring us together. Wow. Discover how Ford F-150 can make the holidays bright. For a limited time only, get an F-150 XLT with 2.9 financing for 66 months plus an extra $1,000, totaling up to $5,250 in total savings.
Why chance deliveries arriving past Christmas when you can pick them up for free in just 1 hour? At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, save time and money on holiday gifts, hosting supplies, and other must-haves with our fast and free drive-through service. It's easy. Just place your order online at farmandfleet.com or on our mobile app and pick it up 1 hour later in our drive-through. We'll send you a text or email to let you know it's ready. When you arrive, get you loaded up and on your way in no time. Shop online, drive-through, and find value at Blaine's Farm.
The shape of the gift gave it away. That didn't matter. This gift would open doors. The gift of music. For beginners to the musically inclined, Lighthold Music has your instrument. Put a piano in that stocking or slide a guitar under the tree. Keep it local. Shop downtown at Lighthold Music. Bring music into your home. Make it a part of their life.
Everybody has an instrument. Yours is at Lighthold Music.
A lifetime of pleasure, satisfaction, and fun. like old music.
It's a robotic money expert.
Clever. How do I start a savings habit?
Famous cabbage.
Savings habit.
Shaving rabbits.
Tech can make life simpler, but when it comes to savings habits, nothing's as simple as BMO. A BMO savings account helps you build the habit with a cash reward every month you save.
Cash reward? Ingenious.
Sardine Fest.
This year's top prize goes to BMO.
I'm just in it for the saving. But it's nice to be recognized. BMO.
Thank you for watching News 8 Now. Expect more.
Well, two of Santa's elves are making an early Christmas delivery. Scott Cooper and Kurt Grunwald are well known at the Family and Children's Center in La Crosse for their handmade wooden toys. This year, they made dinosaurs on wheels for kids that may not otherwise get presents for Christmas. The pair dropped off their bag of gifts this morning. The duo has been making these toys for 23 years and say they don't plan on stopping anytime soon.
We started out to make toys for children who didn't have much for Christmas, and that has not changed. And we still enjoy woodworking, so that hasn't changed, so we'll just keep going.
This year, Kurt and Scott made 52 toys. We'll have a look at what's coming up at 6 when we come back, and we'll have another look at tonight's forecast.
I did know that back pain, foot pain come along with the job of waiting tables. But since getting the arch supports from the Good Feet store, I have had no pain. I'm more positive. It's like opening up a whole new life, like sunshine coming up.
See how we can help you too at the Good Feet store.
Look what you made me do.
Are you flirting with
me? No one will ever
give me
love
your
you.
Password.
This is all your fault.
I swear this will never happen again.
There's no excuse for any type of abuse. Family and Children's Center in Vernon County offers hope and healing from intimate partner violence. If you or someone you know is in danger, call, email, or stop by today.
Do more together this holiday in the Chevy that's right for you. The award-winning Chevy Equinox, the hardworking Chevy Silverado, or the all-new high-tech Chevy Trax. Whatever your plans are this season, do more in a new Chevy. Get 1.9% financing on all 2024 Silverado 1500 pickups. Or current Chevy owners get $5,000 total cash allowance on this Silverado. Chevrolet, together let's drive.
Honey, I'm home. I picked us up a vacuum and I got us some toilet paper.
Well, let's give it a shot and see how it works.
I see trouble for these two.
Oh, come on. Junk. Honey, I'm home. I picked us up a new vacuum and I got us some cat litter.
Will he ever learn?
And another one added to the pile. Honey, I'm home. And this time I went to A1 Vacuum.
My hero.
Craving authentic Mexican flavors? Look no further than Señor Villa. At Señor Villa, we bring the taste of Mexico to your table every day. Join us for our unbeatable $5 lunch specials packed with flavor and value. And don't miss our nightly specials where the fiesta never ends. Señor Villa, where great food meets great value. Visit us today. Señor Villa, the taste of Mexico you've been craving.
Dr. Mehta knows pain.
Oftentimes, I see patients with pain in their knees, their hips, their back, and it's actually coming from their feet.
Her suggestion?
It's as easy as going into a Good Feet store.
Come in for your free arch support fitting.
All right, tonight we'll have some light rain late for La Crosse, especially southern areas. But as you go further north, a different story. That steady light rain especially will continue overnight, so it'll be quite wet. Tomorrow, everything kind of falls back as we get towards the afternoon hours. Once again, it'll still be drizzle and cloud cover even during Saturday evening. And then as we go into the weekend, Sunday should be dry, and you got the temperature change. But then we come back up to the 40s next week.
Yeah, well, if you don't have big plans this weekend, it's wonderful weather tomorrow to stay in. Yeah. Blast the Christmas music, wrap some presents, and bake cookies. We'll see you at 6.